how Google Maps works. How would you know how to get from this point in this map to this point in this map, and which way is the fastest way to go? Because there's almost infinite ways to go, right? And we solve problems like that. If you're somebody who has always loved math and science, who likes using their brain in a very cerebral way, but sees themselves in a career that is in business, that isn't just kind of being an engineer and solving analytical problems all day, but wants to really apply those things to the business world. If you see yourself that way, there's not a single engineering discipline that's more suited for that than information and systems engineering.
Kind of going into my senior year, I figured out I didn't want to work in industrial chemicals for the rest of my life. One of my strengths is engineering and working with people. I was looking at the degree programs that would kind of help me do that moving forward, and the management science and engineering program stuck out to me because it was just combining engineering in a business environment, and I figured that's really what I wanted to do.
At the undergraduate level, our program consists of sort of three different topic areas that combine into the degree. So you learn a little bit about industry and manufacturing, you learn about computers and information systems, and then we have mathematical modeling techniques. That's sort of the engineering part.
After I took physics too, I didn't like the technicality of it, but in industrial engineering in particular, I have the opportunity to look at a problem and look at it from multiple angles and look at different ways that we can solve problems, and that really excites me.
So I started as a chemical engineer because I love chemistry. I mean, you love math, science, you're usually getting up in engineering. I took advanced chemistry here and realized that I didn't love chemistry as much as I thought. And what I do today is solve problems. And I think that's the real difference between an industrial engineer and other engineers, is the breadth of knowledge that you receive as an industrial engineer allows you to solve a lot of problems.
I can say that every industry needs optimization, regardless of government managed industries. One of my students is working now on prisoner assignment in the Pennsylvania Department of Correction. I worked on oil refinery optimization, worked in telecommunication industry problems. So all of the optimization computing methodologies can be used anywhere in the industry and in the world.
What it was 20 years ago, and still is in some cases today, was how do I get more product through a manufacturing facility? Right? All of those same concepts of the complexity of optimizing from beginning to end a process are now being applied to things like marketing. The legacy industrial engineering is logistics, supply chain, manufacturing. The future, while is still those things, is all these new things.
Students that graduate from our department with a degree in industrial and systems engineering, either at the graduate level or at the undergraduate level, are great candidates for jobs in a lot of different industries. So students who study service systems can get jobs in the service industries themselves, in healthcare, in energy, in supply chain and logistics, but they also wind up very attractive candidates for consulting jobs, which especially at the undergraduate level, a lot of our students are very interested in and have great success.
You feel like you like math at heart and that's really what excites you, but you don't want to be a mathematician. You really think you like science and using your brain in those kinds of really challenging ways, but you don't want to be a scientist, it's probably the right degree.